Here's an example of phase one. Both sides have a pre-shared secret key, and they use Diffie-Hellman to establish a new shared key. And they use the pre-shared key to authenticate this newly established shared key. Here's how it works. First, the initiator sends to the responder the crypto that it proposes to use, along with the cookie. The cookie can be easily computed by the initiator and can be easily verified by the responder. For example, this cookie can be computed as a hash over the initiator's IP address and the current timestamp together. The cookie is used to prove that the initiator has done some computation, is serious about following through the protocol. In general, cookies are used to mitigate denial of service attacks where an initiator can send a lot of requests to a responder at no or little cost. The responder then sends back its choice of crypto algorithms and its own cookie to the initiator. Second, here, YI and YR are the public components of the Diffie-Hellman key exchange, and NI and NR are the nonce values of the initiator and the responder. Third, both the initiator and responder compute the same shared key according to Diffie-Hellman key exchange and other keys for the IKE-SA. Fourth, they then exchange hash values to authenticate the newly established key using their pre-shared secret key. The hash is computed using the information that they have just exchanged along with the pre-shared key. We will explain this shortly.